email me, and I'm going to send you the PDF version of this so you'll have all the links, because this journalist seriously web-enabled, and that there's a journey, a tremendous odyssey throughout the internet here by following our links. But those are some additional references for you, and I'll get you going and moving in the direction of further research in this material if you want, if that's what you're looking for. I want to talk about the differences now and characteristics of anaerobic and aerobic exercise. And by the way, none of this is, of course not, proprietary. This isn't CrossFit stuff. This is just basic exercise science. You can find this stuff. There's nothing debated here. When I talk about these are the 10 physical skills and you want them all balanced, I'm sure there's someone out there doesn't think you need a balance. But this other stuff we're talking about here, different between anaerobic and aerobic stuff, it is just non-debatable. All, just like the quadratic equation is a solution to quadratic equations, the quadratic formula is a solution to the quadratic equation. It's not a debatable issue. If you know the stuff, you know that to be the case, and it is not debated amongst sane or credible or knowledgeable people. Anaerobic exercise. It is high power. Well, you can see that in the graph, right?
That's higher than these.
These are higher. This is power. Do you see in the graph in there, by the way, in the journal, the graph there, the axis was percent contribution, and it has to total 100, so it has them all high, and it doesn't really reveal what I wanted to reveal. In other words, out here, this one's gone, so it has to be 100%. And what you'll find at any point here, this plus that is 100, this plus that point there on the graph is 100. Right in here where we have all three working, you'll find if that's at 80, that's probably 10, and there's another or 15, and that's a 5 or whatever it would be, F. So it has to be 100, because at any point, your total energy is 100. So there's a little difference in the graphs, right? They're really not critical. This one is low power. Now let me digress again about power, one more time. I told you it's the first derivative of work, it's work per unit time, it's not just fast, not just strong, but fast and strong. I'll tell you what else power is. It is most exercise physiologists' definition of intensity. Now I know you all heard about intensity and exercise intensity. In the bodybuilding community, they think it's how hard you grunt. It's a lot of intensity, whereas there's a little bit of intensity. Some people think it's puking or not. Some people think it's how discomforted you are. Actually, if you want to find out what is intensity, is defined in exercise physiology parameters as power. Right? Check this out. If we turn to the literature to try and find out what aspects of exercise increase some quality or diminish it, for instance, let's look at bone density. Turns out some exercise has a dramatic impact on bone density, it improves it. Other does not. It will turn out that higher intensity exercise has a greater impact on bone density than lower intensity exercise. This is true of losing fat, of building muscle, of alleviating depression. If we went to our whole big list of things, our 10 general physical skills, what you find is that the way to bring those on quickest, the way to optimize those things, is with greater intensity, not less. Anaerobic exercise is that domain. That is just irrefutable.